All right, so I just upgraded to OpenAI's Operator plan, their pro plan, $200 a month, and I want to see what it's capable of. I just spent some time playing around with it on Facebook Marketplace. It kind of blew my mind, so I thought, okay, I got to hit record on Loom, and let's see what this is capable of, and I'll show you guys what I learn as you learn it too. So I want to see if the operator can go message people in the Dallas-Fort Worth area offering to charge them money to pick up their free piano. This is a business model. I tweeted about it a little while ago. I'm intrigued by it. The model is this. Every day, 40 to 60 people in DFW list a piano on Facebook Marketplace that is free because these things are liabilities. They don't know how to get rid of them. They weigh 600 pounds. And so there's a very lesser known business model of guys that will line up a whole bunch of pianos in the same day. They'll go rent a U-Haul for $50 plus 75 cents a mile. They'll charge $250 per piano. They'll load up the U-Haul, take it to the dump, and throw away the piano. Yes, I know it sounds terrible throwing away these beautiful musical instruments, but at the end of the day, nobody wants these things. Ideally, yes, we donate them to a good cause. Nobody wants them. So we got to do something with them. All right, so let's monetize it. Here's what my prompt is going to be. I want you to open Facebook Marketplace, search the DFW Metroplex for pianos that have a max price of $0. Then I want you to message the seller offering them to pick them up for a $200 fee. Let's see what it does. Okay, let's just see what it does. Okay, so it's already logged into my Facebook account. I did that before hitting record. It wants to make sure that I'm paying attention because Facebook has sensitive data and it doesn't want me to walk away from the computer, but there are ways around this. So it's opening Facebook Marketplace. This is my personal Facebook account. Let's see what it searches. Okay, would have preferred it to search piano instead of plural, but I'm sure it's still fine. It's going to set a max price for $0. That will ensure that every piano that's listed is free. And surely it's going to do something funky here, but that's part of the fun of it. Okay, so it's paused. I found a listing. There are items for pickup in Crowley, Texas. Would you like me to message the seller with your offer to pick up a piano for a $200 fee? Let's test it. How far away is Crowley from Plano, Texas? Now here we're treating it like good old ChatGPT. Oh, wow. It's opening another tab. That's very interesting to me that it isn't pulling on and it's using Bing. I guess that makes sense with the Microsoft. Okay. Yes, you can message anyone within 75 miles of Plano. Go ahead and ask them as well as everyone else. I will come. I don't want to say that because that might dissuade them. See what it does. Let's see what happens. Also, I did buy the domain names pianomovers.com because I think someone needs to do this as a standalone business. All right. So would you like me to send it? I've heard people talk about how the operator won't message people. Like it will not communicate with people, but I think it's going to do it. Boom. Sent. Okay, this is actually crazy to me. This is acting like a virtual assistant or like an actual in-person assistant. It's doing this menial low-level task for me, but it's also thinking as it does it. Pickup only, you'll need a truck to pick those items up. Okay, it's highlighting the standardized message. It's pasting in mine. Oh man, this is amazing. Should I send it? Yes. Let's see if it actually listens to me because there might be some guardrails in place. Sending message. I'm going to take it a step further here in a minute. I'm going to have it log all of these in a spreadsheet all by itself. So while it does this, I'm going to go to this spreadsheet entitled Operator. There's nothing in it. It's completely blank. And let's see if it listens to me and it sends this without my permission. It did it. It is communicating with people without my input or permission. This is amazing. Please log all of these in a spreadsheet. In this spreadsheet, make appropriate columns. So now I'm going to ask it to do something totally different from what it's doing now. It's going to make a spreadsheet for me, and it's going to log these items. So video is cool, but you know what's better? Long form audio via podcast and my newsletter, tkopod.com. Go there to subscribe for free to my newsletter. It's one email a week, very tactical, 1500 words per email. And then go to my audio podcast, 3 episodes a week, stuff like this. You're going to love it. All free, no sleazy sales pitch, tkopod.com. This is so crazy to me that these people that I'm messaging are one of the first people in the history of the world to unknowingly have a conversation with artificial intelligence. This is absolutely incredible. Pianos of all things. Who would have thought? Okay, now here you can see in the window what it's doing in my Google Sheet. And if I go to my Google Sheet, it's just, it's like an actual human's in here. Look at that. Freaking amazing. Oh my gosh, this is so cool. 60 pianos a day. Let's say 50. Let's say 10% of them agree. That's a day. Okay. So let's say 40. 40 times 7, 280 listed a week. Let's say 10% of them agree to have it come picked up for $200 because they got to do something with it, especially if they're moving. It has to go. That's 28 people a week agreeing to pay $200. That's $5,600 a week. Okay. You're going to have some costs, some gas, some labor. Those pianos are not light. That could be a six-figure business that is primarily run by AI. Now, granted, you know, the low-level stuff is done by AI. The heavy stuff is done by me. But man alive, look at this. It's making a spreadsheet. To resume, okay, so yada, yada, yada. May conflict with your instructions. Mark safe. So if I navigate away from this tab, it's going to pause after a few seconds or 30 seconds, a minute, I don't know. But I can always have this open in my other monitor right over there. Now, but it's not adding the link to the listings. Don't forget to add the link to each listing. Okay, what's it gonna do? It's adding the links. It's going back. Is it the right one? Pianos, organs, office, kids, desk. That's the first one. Oh man, it's freaking doing it. And then I'm gonna go a step further. I'm gonna say, can you monitor these messages and add a new column with a checkbox and check the box if someone responds? Let's just start with that. If I were to launch this business today, I would literally hire a virtual assistant and pay them $4 to $8 an hour to do exactly what this AI is doing right here. I don't know why it put nothing in column A. That is a little curious. But can I add checkboxes? Response received. What's interesting to me is it's behaving just like a human. All right, where's the checkbox? It seems to be thinking a good bit here. Oh man. It's going a step further. Okay. I thought it was going to do like a drop-down response. It's just kind of doing the more tedious way of adding a checkbox. And it's checking the box even though a response isn't received. Leave the box unchecked. Oh my gosh, it looks like I might have a message. It looks like I might have a message. This is so cool. I'm not literally on the edge of my seat, but I'm figuratively on the edge of my seat right now. Now it never unchecked the boxes. So it's telling me it needs a pin, but it doesn't. It just needs to click on marketplace. There it is. It's freaking amazing. Okay, look at that. Someone responded. We are giving things away. I don't want to pay to haul them off. He responded to AI. Yeah, you're doing it the opposite way. Check the box if they respond and leave unchecked otherwise. Oh, Derek, if you only knew. Well, what are you doing? What are you doing here? It's kind of freaking me out because it's like sometimes when I'm working, I click on the wrong thing, I'm just distracted. it's almost like it's acting like it has ADHD. Maybe is this a parallel universe? And this is a digital representation of me? Okay, it's not unchecking the boxes, but my mind is sufficiently blown. We've been recording this for 15 minutes and we got someone to respond. We messaged three people and it could keep doing this. It could do this all night. So I don't even know where to go, but I hope that this excites you. And tkopod.com to join my newsletter so you can learn about this stuff in real time.